Welcome to the DVM 365. I'm Associate Content Specialist Julie Scheidegger. As we enter 2014, the AVMA continues to monitor various pieces of legislation that would affect the veterinary profession. Depending on the legislation, the AVMA's lobbying arm may take several approaches, ranging from pursuit of passage to no action on the issue. Current issues include the Veterinary Medicine Mobility Act, which passed the Senate January 8th, the All Soaring Tactics Act, and the Veterinary Medicine Loan Repayment Program Enhancement Act. To see the full AVMA legislative agenda, go to dvm360.com/legislation2014. Ceva Animal Health has acquired generic drug and supplement manufacturer Sojival from a French industrial conglomerate. Under the agreement, Sojival becomes a subsidiary of Ceva. While both companies have a presence in cardiology, pain management, and certain livestock products, their complementary areas of expertise enhance Ceva's growth potential, company leaders say. Ceva's North American CEO, Craig Wallace, says, "We are eager to move forward with this integration." Build it and they will come doesn't apply to your practice's website, but Dr. Lori Hess says you can boost your website signal with search engine optimization.
I think the easiest way for veterinarians to market their practice better would be to focus not just on their website, but on search engine optimization. All vets think that they should just get a great website, get it up, get it out in cyberspace, and everyone will come. But unfortunately, that's not the truth. We know that different people in different geographic areas search with different terms, and you can have a terrific website with great graphics. It can be beautiful and wonderful and describe your practice perfectly, but if no one sees it, no one is going to come to you. So you really need to spend a little bit of time and a little bit of money and hire somebody professional who can optimize your website with the appropriate keywords that people in your area search so that they can find you and come to your practice.
Are there times when a less than pleasant colleague is running the show? Consultant Bash Hallow has advice on how to make the clinic mean girl an ally.
Well, in my experience, the mean girl in charge is often being mean because she's frustrated that she can't get the job done like she would want to get it done. She has a vision for how things should play out, and for whatever reason, she's unable to accomplish it. So my recommendation for you, if you're in that situation, is to find a time when the mean girl isn't being so mean, and go up to her and let her know that you've got her back, that you understand what she's trying to accomplish at the practice, and you'll be an ally for her to do that. And then, if you feel like it's not pushing the envelope too much, you might want to let her know that the way that she's behaving is antithetical to what she's trying to accomplish. That might be helpful, but you might have to go in baby steps. Probably the first thing would just be to let her know that you appreciate what she's trying to do and that you're there to help her out, I think would be the first step.
Backyard poultry is gaining in popularity, and avian veterinarians aren't the only ones seeing more of these species in their practices. Here, Dr. Eric Klafecki has advice for practitioners interested in expanding their expertise in this area.
Poultry is probably one of the fastest growing aspects of avian medicine. Even for avian specialists, if you ask them what's the most common bird they're seeing, it's usually going to be chickens. And so it's a nice niche that other practitioners can get into, and a lot of times you may have no choice where your dog or cat client comes in and wants you to know things about it. Many times what is one of the best steps to take as far as getting involved with it is talking to your local extension agent and getting information, PDFs or handouts that you can provide to the client as to how to build a coop, how to set it up, how to have the birds working with that. Now you do have to remember when you're working with chickens is that they are a food animal, whether they're being used for the eggs or at some stage being used for meat. So that's going to limit a lot as to what kind of medications you can put in there, and you want to be very careful that you follow that law or you have that client sign a release form. Otherwise, it's very good to get educated also in how to take care of birds in general. So if you're comfortable with birds, chickens are a nice little addition to add in there. But if you're not, these are often, in my opinion, a great bird species to get started with because they're not quite as touchy or can hurt you as badly as some of the parrot birds or other birds that might be coming into your practice.
We hope you've enjoyed this edition of The Five. If you have suggestions for future shows, email us at dvm360@advancedstar.com. And for the latest news, medicine, and business information, be sure to visit dvm360.com every day. Make the clinic mean girl an ally.